G'day, didgeridoo smart person. My name's Dylan. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Welcome to the Physics Club. So fair warning, I think this show is pretty brutal. I looked up the trailer and there were a few people getting eaten. So if you're fairly squeamish, maybe this isn't the video for you. But I don't know about you, I'm feeling pretty hungry. And a few of my eagle eye subscribers have noticed that my fridge is in the shot. And they've commented on other videos asking what's in his fridge. So let me just get over here, see what we got. All right. I think I've mentioned on the channel before, but I'm as content as a cucumber. So let's watch some people get in. It's probably just going to make me look like more of a psychopath, isn't it? Some people were commenting on my other videos saying that I look like a psychopath because I never laugh at any of the jokes. It takes a lot to make me laugh. Like, I'm always smiling at jokes. I'm a smiler. There's one scary looking lady. Don't eat the mom. Surely they're not gonna do it. No. They're doing it. Holy dolly. She just got ripped in half. Oh God. But that reminds me actually. I wonder how much force it would take to actually rip someone in half. Just adding to that psychopath title, aren't I? Well, I don't know about ripping someone in half, but I do remember a calculation. I tried to work out how much force you'd need to apply to pull someone's arm off. I don't know why I did this. But anyway, I worked it out and it was something like 85,000 newtons, which is a lot, but I think these giant beings would be more than capable of that. But anyway, just an interesting fact for you. Anyway, moving on. So brutal. Such great music. All right, let's talk about this maneuver gear, this 3D maneuvering equipment. Could something like that be realistic? So they have like two grappling hooks, grabs onto things, propels them through the air. And they have some kind of gas chamber, I think they said, that it's compressed gas and it's used to fire the hooks and also like launch them. No, it's not very realistic. They're moving around very quickly and in, you know, multiple axes. So you'd be experiencing many Gs. And I don't think you'd be fainting every time you launched in any which way. I don't think a grapple hook would be able to grip strongly enough onto things. I also don't think that compressed gas would be able to give you such thrust. But I could be wrong, so if someone's out there who'd like to correct me, feel free. So yeah, I don't think it's very realistic whatsoever. Not to mention one small slip and you're probably going to go splat on a wall. It looks like they're traveling at, 100 kilometers per hour, so I don't think it is a great idea for fighting these titans. So they just mentioned that these titans need sunlight. So they're theorizing that they actually get energy from photosynthesis, which is pretty cool. But something about photosynthesis, which you might not know, is that we really don't completely understand it just yet. Scientists have long understood how photosynthesis works, but only up to a point. The very fine details are actually very hard to discern. Everything takes place at the molecular level and the atomic level. You've got proteins that are hard to see, you've got photons and electrons coming and going. And so a lot of these processes are quantum mechanical. Photosynthesis actually relies on quantum physics. It relies on the laws of nature at its most granular. So the people who work on this stuff, the people who are trying to figure out, discern the fine details of photosynthesis, are known as biophysicists. So understanding how nature does it will help us figure out what materials we need to bring together to, you know, artificially harvest light and have a green source of renewable energy. Understanding how this natural process works will also greatly improve the efficiency of modern solar energy devices and possibly even make them far smaller. Hold up. So these walls are 50 meters high. They built them in 100 years? How big is the piece of land the wall is surrounding? All right, so I just found that the radius to the furthest wall is 480 kilometers, which gives a diameter for the whole place 960 kilometers. So if you work it out, if you assume it's a perfect circle, that gives an area of 720,000 square kilometers, which is huge because that's like the size of Afghanistan or Texas. So that is a monumental piece of land that they've built a wall around. So the Great Wall of China, I think it took them about 2,000 years to build, and that's meant to be about 21,000 kilometers. So if you work out the circumference of this village in Attack on Titan, its radius is 480 kilometers. So, you know, the circumference is C equals 2 pi r, so that'll give you 3,000 kilometers, which is 1/7 of the Great Wall's distance. So, you know, it should take more like 280 years to build this wall, Maria. So it's actually not too far off, so that's impressive. And that's if humans, right? Who knows? It hasn't told us how this wall was built, so there could be some weird stuff going on, I'm sure. All right, I think I've had enough of watching people get eaten, so please subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys next time. Catch ya.